Hi, welcome back to the next installment of Deadly Affirmations, the video novel. Today we're going to begin the 13th chapter, Express Yourself. Here we go. Saturday morning found Patience cleaning the garage, completely absorbed in her work. She had slept like a dog until Abraxas had decided that she had had enough sleep and should attend to important matters. Feed the cat. Cat fed, morning coffee brewed and drunk, couple of huge, gorgeously ripe strawberries down the hatch, stem, calyx, and all, a recent change in her strawberry scarfing methodology, but one that Patience told herself knowingly added to her daily intake of fiber. And her work clothes donned, Patience headed out to the garage to clean that mess up. She opened the garage door and pulled her car out into the driveway to give her some room to work. She began with the wall closest to the house, the gardening side. She took the rakes, one garden rake, one shrub rake, two leaf rakes, one wide and one narrow, and shovels, a spade, a scoop, a utility, and two for snow. A bunch of miscellaneous tools with handles, a hatchet, a fiberglass-handled splitting axe, a mattock, a girly 6-pound sledgehammer, a rubber mallet, a couple of pruning shears, a couple of trowels, a weeder, a pruning saw, and a collapsible tree pruner out into the driveway and cleaned them all, washing them off and setting them out to dry in the morning sun. She went back into the garage and brought out 3 pairs of garden gloves, a couple of watering cans, 2 pairs of gardening shoes, a pair of gaily flowered green and blue plastic wellies, a lawn mower, a half-full 1-gallon plastic gas can, a bottle of oil, and a spare spark plug for the mower. By then, that wall was empty. Patience fired up her leaf blower and blew the dust and dirt and cobwebs out of that part of the garage. Then she went to the back wall. She cleaned the work table and brought the tools hung on the pegboard above it out to be cleaned. From the shelf underneath the table, she brought out the power tools, 2 electric drills, 1 corded and 1 battery-powered, a circular saw, a jigsaw, the little Dremel kit, and an electric sander that she put aside to be taken to the Goodwill. Then there were the shelves in the corner, a couple of gallons of paint for the interior walls of her house, pints of touch-up paint for the molding, 2 pints of wood stain, 1 walnut, 1 black cherry, a can of tongue oil, a gallon of deck resurfacer on the bottom shelf, paintbrushes and rollers and trays and other paraphernalia on the next shelf, then fertilizer and insecticides, organic and not, and weed killers, organic and not, on the next, and then on the top shelf a bunch of stuff that didn't really fit anywhere else. Drain cleaner, Ritex for the septic tank, fungicide, and an old rusty tin lithothermometer. These came out next. In the corner were the garden stakes, metal and bamboo, and her treasured tobacco stakes, a roll of Velcro plant tie, a roll of twine. It all came out, and then that wall and table and shelves were blown out and cleaned. Finally, the side of the garage, the furthest from her house, where she kept her bicycle, her girlhood skateboard Patience had saved up for 8 months to get her Santa Cruz Rat Fink Slasher, rode it to and from school, and kept it within reach until she got her driver's license years later. A cheap Walmart paddleboard, and her sweet 13-foot camo sit-on ocean kayak. A collection of softball bats and balls, golf clubs, tennis rackets, disc golf discs, a half-deflated football, a couple of soccer balls, a basketball, 2 lax sticks, her brine superlight and her mom's precious hickory with the leather netting, and a couple of field hockey sticks from her high school and college days. She took it all out into the driveway and cleaned it all before she blew out and cleaned that wall. Patience was cleaning the kayak when the ground began to shake and the windows of her house began to rattle. She looked around her, hoping that it wasn't an earthquake. There'd never been a tremor in River City, but the world was changing. And then, rolling down the street behind her, the driver probably smoking indoors, sipping on gin and juice, a little POS car with lots of stickers and a cracked rear window lazily headed for the fest. Gerald, that asshole! When Patience had finished putting the garage back together, she found that she had the electric sander, a couple of cans of dried-out paint, a bag of Chlordane, and the old thermometer left over. She would take the sander to Goodwill and the paint cans to the dump. But the organophosphate termite poison and the little glass tube of elemental mercury gave Patience other ideas. Patience's morning guide and affirmation helped plant those other ideas in her mind. Regardless of the medium, people flourish when they find a means of expression. I find writing therapeutic, the page had read. Well, thought Patience, in a moment of unexpected enlightenment, I find killing assholes therapeutic. I find that it centers my life. It soothes me. It is stimulating, and yet it fills my life with serenity. My creativity is the act that affirms and signifies my respect for all that I am and I can be. Card seemed to agree. Number 69, my world is a peaceful, loving, and joy-filled place to live. All of these words had simmered in her subconscious for hours and provided the impetus for what patient Saturday afternoon would bring.